Oh, hi. Let's talk about lithium trolling motor batteries and sealed lead acid batteries.
Right here I have a LiPuls product manual for a 12 volt 100 amp hour lithium trolling motor battery. It's a group 24. Right here is an Everstart deep cycle marine sealed lead acid battery. This is what I have been using. I've been wanting to try lithium and do some videos on that for my trolling motor that I made. A few weeks ago, I created a DIY wireless remote control trolling motor with a regular off-the-shelf Endura Minn Kota transom mount motor. And you can see the project box I made for that. I'll have a link to that video in my description. But today I want to talk about the differences between the lithium. Well, this is a lithium ion battery. They call it a lithium ion battery, but it's also a lithium iron phosphate deep cycle battery. So the actual chemistry that's happening inside of this battery uses lithium iron phosphate to create, I guess, ions that it can convert into electricity. Honestly, I think it's kind of magic, but it, I guess, is science. This one is specifically labeled as a trolling motor. And you'll get this product manual. It has a bunch of information that kind of explains how to use this, how to test it, how to charge it. I think it's a pretty informative brochure. This is saying to recharge every 3 months. It has safety and warning information. It explains differences between lead acid battery charging and lithium ferrous or iron phosphate battery charging. It also has this kind of quick information guide that you can look at. It comes with all of that. It has smart technology built into it for charging and discharging of the battery. Packaging comes pretty well packaged, considering sometimes I'll get something that's not even in a box from Amazon. LiPuls sent this to me. They had seen my trolling motor video and offered this to me to test out. So I had been wanting to purchase one of these. The price is pretty good. I would say a sealed lead acid battery is still about half the cost of a lithium battery, but the cost of lithium is a lot less than it used to be. This is the battery itself. Already I can tell the difference in weight. It also comes with some little mounting posts for this. I'm gonna take these off and I'm just gonna screw these down. About the same size. It'll fit into this battery box that I have. And the weight difference is why a lot of people, especially kayakers, will opt for lithium, because they can get the same 100 amp hour 12 volt battery compared to the sealed lead for roughly half the weight. So this comes in around 26 pounds and this one is just over 50 pounds. So big difference in weight, and you could effectively have two of these on the boat compared to one of these weight wise. Now cost is going to cost a lot more than this if you want to have two of these. For those of you who are interested in knowing how to charge this for the first time, I have a Everstart Maxx charger. It's a 50 amp charger. I highly recommend it. It comes with a lithium setting or a lead acid setting. So I can charge this battery and I can charge this battery with it. It has multiple choices. You can do an engine start if you're using this on your car. It'll give you the max 50 amp engine start voltage. You can also check your alternator on your car with that. And it all does this automatically when you're going to charge this. You don't have to worry about these buttons when you go to charge these. But what you're going to do, if the LI is off on this, that means it's for sealed lead acid. And if you hit LI, that means lithium. So you're going to clamp this to your battery post, red to red and black to black. And it's gonna It's going to check with that. It's going to show the voltage. And then it's going to start charging if it needs to charge. So it's showing 13.1 volts. And it's showing it is 75% charged. And it'll start charging and go all the way up to 100% or full F. This is a really good charger. I can't remember what it costs, but I will put a link to it in my description. But I'm just going to charge this and we'll come back when it's fully charged. This one I already charged, so I'm not going to worry about that. But when this gets to 100%, it goes to what's called a maintaining, and it'll just do a really drip voltage and bring the voltage down to and bring the charging wattage down to almost nothing, just to make sure that this is continues to be charged. The thing about lithium is you can take this all the way almost down to zero when you're using it and discharging it, by like using my trolling motor. This one, when it gets down to 50%, you want to stop. You don't want to take a sealed lead acid battery below 50% because it starts to reduce its effectiveness in charging and keeping a charge. So these are becoming more popular because of how long they can maintain their charge. Which means this one boasts about 4,000 to 5,000 cycles. We'll see about that. I just got it, so I can't even talk to how many cycles this has been run, because this will be the first cycle it's ever had. And when they say cycles, they mean charging and discharging it by using it, taking a draw from it, whether you're using it to power a trolling motor, you're using it to start cars or motors, outboard motors. We'll see how long this lasts, if it actually runs that many cycles. Okay, so this is now charged. Actually, I might just put it onto this one and let it maintain. To install this onto this trolling motor, I'm gonna unscrew this. Normally I have this in a battery box, but for now I'm gonna just screw this in. The red wire to the red post and the black wire to the black post. And tighten this up with a rubber handled wrench or socket set or whatever you want to use. Just tighten it up pretty good. You don't want it shorting. And since I'm using this DIY trolling motor that I made, I built these quick connects. So this one goes to the actual trolling motor, and this one powers it. This port right here powers it from the battery. I'll put a link to this project because it's a fairly inexpensive way to take a fairly cheap trolling motor and make it a wireless remote controlled trolling motor. It also has speed control right here. So I'm gonna make sure everything's off first. I'm gonna fill up this trash can with water to simulate this trolling motor working in the lake or a river. I have water in the tank now. This is gonna simulate the drag that a lake or river would put on your trolling motor propeller. I have a speed controller here for forward and reverse, and I'm going to turn this up to roughly 85 to 90%. I'm going to go all the way up and back it off. And now I'm going to turn this on and just let it run until it starts to wear out. I'm gonna lower the speed. I'm going to raise the speed. Still going strong. Gonna let it go for a while. So now I'm gonna check on my charger to see what it's looking like. I'm gonna take this black post off first, and then we'll remove the red post. Hook it up very similar to your car battery. Then we're gonna take it into here and we're gonna see where we are on the charger. I'm gonna disconnect the maintainer on the Everstart, and this immediately defaults to lithium, so I don't have to hit this button. It defaults to that. So I'm gonna hook up the lithium battery and start charging it to full again. It'll kick on automatically. It's a fan to keep the charger cooled off while it's charging. It's running a lot of amperage to this, so it's running 9.9 amps to the lithium battery as it's charging. And it's basically running the amount that this battery is telling it to, because like I said, it has smart technology in it to tell it how to charge and how far it needs to be charged. Once it gets to full, it will send a message to this charger that it can just be maintained, which keeps it from overcharging. Although I didn't run this all the way to empty, I can already tell that it has a longer capacity than one of these. Sealed lead acid battery has been the long-term answer, but we've moved into a new frontier with these lithiums that are cost-effective. I will have links to this product in my description. I'll also put a link to the Everstart. I'll include a link to my trolling motor wireless remote project that I feature in this, and I hope this was helpful. If this video helped you decide on lithium over sealed lead acid at all, I would appreciate if you give this video a like. Definitely leave a comment. If you have pros or cons that you'd like to add, feel free to add them in the comments. I plan to do a lot more projects using this lithium battery versus a sealed lead acid. I am thinking about doing a small solar project. I've been pretty happy with this battery charger. It really seems to be able to jump between lithium and sealed lead acid car batteries and trolling motor batteries. So give this a try, or you probably want to get some sort of smart charger like this.